Hi, I'm Meg Thompson. This is Video Voters Guide, a service of the League of Women Voters, a 102-year-old nonpartisan organization that believes democracy depends on informed and active participation. For election and candidate information, be sure to visit our online site, vote411.org, before you mark your ballot. Today, we have candidate Mark Perlman running for West Linn City Council. Welcome, Mark.
Well, hi, thank you for having me.
Wonderful to have you here. Could you please tell us why you're running for City Council?
Well, I've always had an interest in politics, and I've had been involved in several helping people with their campaigns, and as a president of the faculty union at Western Oregon University, we were involved with political lobbying for educational things, and they would often call me and say, hey, there's a legislative hearing over at the Capitol. Can you go and talk about this bill? Since I lived very close to the Capitol in Salem. And so I just thought, I'm going to begin to get involved, and this is a good place to start, and especially because this is a replacement for someone who resigned, so that there's technically an incumbent, there's not, you know, but he's only been in there for a month. So I thought, well, there's not an incumbent who's entrenched, so it would be a good chance. But mainly, I just think this fits in with my values of helping people and making sure that decisions that affect us all are done thoughtfully and considering all the various complicated conditions that affect them. So
given the issue of replacing this position in office, how would you work to restore the collaboration and trust among the council members and the mayor to work effectively?
Well, I think this is kind of a special case of one person who was behaving in inappropriate ways. So I don't think it's a systemic problem with the city government as a whole, but I would like to collaborate with people and listen to their viewpoints and find out why they think what they think. And if there are places of common ground that we can agree on, that's important to find. And then when there's disagreements, you negotiate and try and find some kind of collaborative compromise. And I think the city council is in better shape than it was, say, 10 years ago, when there was a lot of disagreement and kind of infighting. So I think this is a kind of specific case of one person who was behaving poorly and not necessarily a problem with the whole council.
So can you be specific about three goals you'd like to achieve within your work as the council member?
Yes. Well, one thing that I think is very important is that we make wise decisions about the kinds of development that we're going to have in the city of West Linn. And I think that when we do green light development projects, which we should when they're appropriate, that when developers make promises about preserving trees or making a buffer between like the middle school and the rest of the community, it's important that we hold them to those promises. And in the past, that hasn't always been the case. And there, I've talked to a lot of people in various neighborhoods who, that seems to me to be one of their biggest concerns, is that development happens and various things are promised, and then those things don't all pan out the way that they were promised. Another thing I think is a very important that we protect the environment. I mean, West Linn is a beautiful place. That's why, one of the reasons why we live here, and we need to protect the environment. And the other thing that I think is important is that we work to reduce traffic congestion on our main streets, Highway 43 and Willamette Falls Drive. And we make roads accessible for pedestrians and for bicycles. We're doing some of that, but that we need to do more of that.
With those important goals in mind, how would you work effectively between the council, the city and state and county governmental issues to deal with the specific planning so there is follow through and effectiveness?
Well, one of the things that we need to figure out is why aren't these things happening that should be happening? The city has certain obligations to not only approve planning proposals, but also give out building permits, but also has a role in making sure that the plans are adhered to. And right now, I'm not exactly sure why the follow through isn't happening. And so the first thing I would want to do is find out, what are we doing? Why are there some times where things aren't happening the way they should? And is it a matter of money? Is it a matter of we don't have enough people doing the legwork? Is it a matter of policy? So one thing that we need to do is just have conversations about what's going on, what's the cause of the problem, and figure out a solution. And, it's difficult. West Linn city government doesn't have vast sums of money. So we have to be careful to spend it wisely. And, this is a collaborative thing. I mean, these are big projects. Roads are things that are between the city and the county and the state, and there are complicated interactions with those various things. And some development, like building of schools, is an issue where the school district and the city have to work together. Sometimes that doesn't always happen smoothly. And we need to make connections and try and get people on various different departments and various different areas of government to work together better.
So how would you help deal with the affordable housing crisis in your local jurisdiction?
Well, that is a difficult thing. We have some projects that are being proposed of building multiple unit housing. And I understand that there is some pushback in neighborhoods of people who they're not thrilled about that. And we have to make some outreach to the community to communicate that these things are important and not everybody is going to be living in a huge house on a half acre or whatever. And that there is benefit to the community of having affordable housing. I think the number one challenge is that there are a lot of residents who are not necessarily on board with having affordable housing units because they feel like they're, those things might be some kind of a threat to the character of the neighborhood that they live in that has single family houses in it. And so one of the things we need to do is have a conversation with members of the community and make them understand that the value of affordable housing. And, West Linn, the prices of houses in West Linn is certainly very, very high. And it's pricing a lot of people out of living here, which is a shame because, I think it's a wonderful community to be in.
Well, thank you for your perspective. In closing, could you summarize why voters should vote for you and how specifically you're going to make a difference?
Well, one of the things is, I haven't been elected to public office, but I have experience. I was on the Public Employees Benefit Board, which is a statewide board and oversees health benefits for 150,000 state employees. So I have experience in the kind of decision making that goes on in a government agency. And I've also been a leader and being a president of the Western Oregon University Federation of Teachers. I'm a natural leader, and as a philosopher with a PhD, I'm good at persuading people and coming up with reasons why we need to do various things and having conversations with people. And, you know, I value things like protecting the environment, civil rights, reproductive rights, education, social justice, and supporting the arts. I'm also a musician. My various roles in life have all been in various ways helping people. And what I want to do in West Linn is help the people of West Linn have a government that works for them and listens to them. And that's, I think, very important that people not only are listened to, but that what they say about how they think things should be run is reflected in the decisions that get made. It's not enough to just listen to people. You have to pay serious attention to what they want and have those things put into practice. And I think some voters are frustrated that there are all these forums, but what they say doesn't influence specific decisions as much as it should. And I think it's very important that not only that we listen to people, but that we take what they say seriously and have that inform the actual decisions that are made. And I think I can do a good job of that, of collaborating with people and communicating with people and bringing the policies of the city in line with what the residents of West Linn want.
Thank you very much, Mark, for your perspective. Mark Perlman, candidate for West Linn City Council. And voters, don't forget to visit the League of Women Voters vote411.org for complete candidate and ballot information before you mail in your ballot. Thank you very much.